28th of August 2022. And this is where the video diary began. On the end of that island, on that patch of gravel there. On the 11th of July 2010, 12 years ago. I noticed that after the recent rises of the river level, it's gone right back down again, and the weir itself is completely dry. Well, this is where the video diary started all those years ago, on the 11th of July 2010, over 12 years ago. And it's very apt, because this will be the last, this will be number 500. I never thought there would be as many, but anyway, this is number 500. And when I first started course fishing, I was looking at catching barbel. The only videos on the internet were by manufacturers. Tackle and bait, obviously trying to flog you their gear. There was next to nothing about the ordinary hobby angler on the bank. So I thought, well, I'll start making videos of my experiences, good, bad or indifferent, thinking that there would be other people like me who would find them interesting. And that's how it's turned out. I mean, there's almost 9,500 subscribers. Not quite 10,000. They've always just been a video diary, that's it. There have been videos on saying this is how you do it. As a science educator for most of my adult life, I've always been in favour of the discovery method, investigations, do the research, read the books, look at videos, ask around, ask people who are experienced, and then decide what I'm going to do, and then do it. If it doesn't work, amend it, and then keep amending it, and still amending it years later. Those are the things you pick up on the bank. I mean, far too often, people try and take the shortcut. You meet them quite regularly on the bank. You know, what's the best peg to fish? Well, try them all and see which you find is the best. You know, what's the bait, what bait are you using? Where do you cast it to? What length are you hooking? What size hooks are you? What kind of hooks are you? All the time. Similarly, you get people who are saying, you know, which is the best venue for barbel, or which is the best venue for grilling, or whatever. Well, try all of them and see how you get on. I mean, that's one of the great joys of angling, is the experimentation, gradually getting better and better as you gain experience, particularly with rivercraft. And you can have all the gear you like, if you don't know where to cast to, you don't know where barbel are likely to be hanging about, then you're going to find it very disappointing. So I hope the videos in a small way have helped people to solve the problem, and to encourage more people to take up fishing, particularly on rivers. When I first started cross fishing, having been a fly fisherman for donkey's years, I noticed it was most of the fishing on the rivers was done by a rapidly shrinking number of elderly anglers, if I could put it like that. Basically old blokes, a bit like myself now. But I see more and more young people taking up angling. Similarly, membership of angling clubs was, well, it's disappeared off the bottom of the charts. And a number of angling clubs disappeared, but now when I look at membership, I'm encouraged to see that they're far more healthy than they were before. And maybe these videos have helped a little bit to do that as well. So there'll be no video diary as such. It takes hours and hours and hours to edit these things, and I'd like to spend a bit more time on those things which I've been neglecting a sizable number in the future. So I'll continue to do the video, but it'll only be highlights, and it won't be posted as often on the internet. There'll be none of the minutiae, which I quite enjoy, you know, the flowers and the bird life, sneaky little mice and swimming squirrels. There'll be very little of that, I'm afraid. And for those of you who might be wondering, no, I'm not about to fall off my perch, at least I hope not. And I hope to be fishing for many years to come. Anyway, a final note, just like to say thank you very much to the subscribers, all of you. And thank you for the comments, 99.999, whatever it is, which have been, for the most part, very positive. But you do get the occasional negative one. And then again, the trolls everywhere. Miserable, I guess. And for those of you hoping to see my rod disappear into the river, well, I'm sorry to have to disappoint you. If it doesn't go in, the chances are it won't be on video. Anyway, I look forward to seeing you on the bank. I'll still be around, I'm not going anywhere. I'll still be checking books for my local angling association. And don't forget, join your local angling association. You get great benefit from it. And similarly, don't forget to support your local tackle shop. The number of those which have disappeared in my time is quite surprising. So keep supporting them whenever you can. Anyway, see you on the bank. Take care. Bye-bye. Time for fishing. Well, all in daylight, only just right. Finish off. Tremendous fight. It's not a really big fish either.
Wonderful. Big fish.
A bit out of its tail there. Which is a shame. Apart from that, it's a wonderful thing.
Oh, that's really pleasing.
I think that'll do for the night. It's 10:30. Call it a day.
Big bright moon behind the trees. The stars are really bright tonight. Right in front of me is the plough of the North Star. I've got to pick them up on this video. Well, we've had 3 nice fish. Just to end the diary. It covers everything. I mean, I've fished from Marcia in India and tiger fish in South Africa, fish the Royalty on the Hampshire Avon and the Star, and the Wye, but nothing quite like the River Swell, this glorious river in North Yorkshire. So to end the diary, take care, tack lines, cheerio. Final video, which is the next one, which is not part of the diary at all. It answers all those questions I've been fending off for years. How do you do it? How do you catch barbel? Well, if you ask around, you'd probably get as many answers as there are barbel anglers. Most of them different.